begin to quote the scripture, as he begin to quote the scripture, the devil had to leave him alone. And after the third time, the Bible lets me know that Jesus was triumphant, and he continued on and what God wanted to do. My brothers and my sisters, if we're going to overcome the sin that is within us, we need to be transparent. In other words, we need to be open and let people know that we've got some faults. Let people know that we do sin sometimes. As you can tell us in a man, when they ask you, what's the difference between you and me? You can tell them like Tiger Woods will say, when it comes to golf, I don't practice golf. Look at me in verse number 25. And Paul said, I thank God through Jesus Christ our Lord. So then, with this mind, I myself serve the law of God, but the flesh was with the flesh, the law of sin. And I've already said that these verses are a little confusing, but all Paul is saying is that when I'm in the flesh, then I serve the law. Because I've got Jesus, because I've been transformed by the renewal of my mind, because I walk after the Spirit and not after the flesh. When the devil brings in the cross, then I rebound and I resist him and I stand on the word of my God. And if we want to be successful, we can't stand on how long we've been in church. Straight into sexual sin. his heart. Oh, what God's your heart? But he said, know ye not that the friendship of this world is enemy with God? Whosoever therefore be a friend of the world is the enemy of God. Have we overcome the sin within us? Might be to change our friends. Do not think that the scripture says in vain. The spirit that dwells in us must have been in you. But he giveth more grace. Therefore he said, God raised, resisted the proud, but giveth grace unto the humble. And if I could pause for just a minute, I know what time it is, and I'm almost done. For just a few minutes. This is what he said one more time. God resisted the proud, but he gave the grace unto the humble. What we need in the church, that's a proud road. Don't you know how long I've been in this church? Don't you know who my parents were in this church? Don't you know what schools I've gone to? I'm matriculated at. But I heard what the Bible said. When you stop letting it be about you, how many things you've done in the church? How many auxiliaries have you been present in? How much your parents or your family has given to the church? And realize that none of it came by you. You come to the world and God gave it to you. And mourn and weep. Let your laughter be turned to mourning and your joy to heaviness. Humble yourselves in the sight of the Lord, and he, not man, says he shall lift you up. I'm almost there. 1 Corinthians 10 says, now these things happen unto them for examples, that they are written for our admonition, unto whom the ends of the world are. Wherefore let him that thinketh he standeth take heed lest he falls. Another word, those that think that you are mature and that you are above reproach. Those that think that you can control yourself, that you control your will. Don't get too high, because the higher you get, the more down you gotta fall. I feel a little quick testimony. That God had worked in me. I thought that I could control my will. I thought I was above reproach. And I looked down on everyone that wasn't at the stake.
Let my sisters and brothers know that I want.
everybody in. Because it makes no difference how I look on the outside. There are things that I struggle with each and every day. And the truth be told, each of us have something that we struggle with. And when we're transparent with one another, what we find out is that, no, I'm not the only one that's going through this. But you can't find that out if you hide it. Then we need to face our temptation. Realize that, yeah, I do have a problem. I need to leave the ice cream alone. I need to stop looking at these women.
Yo,
I need to put the magazine down.
Yeah.
I need to leave these tapes alone. I need to leave that other woman's husband alone. I need to leave that other.